Hello and welcome back to another episode of The Infected. As you can see, I've managed to fill up my wood shop. It's nice and full again. I also finished the ingot building. I placed a few in already. I haven't finished them yet. And I did also finish my copper extractor, my first one, which has a bit more copper again. So let's put that in here. I also finished my first iron extractor, which has another iron for me. So let's do that. Put that in as well. And let's take a look at our greenhouse. We just need some more nails. So if I fire this one up, I should get the iron I need for the nails, and while we wait on that, we can go do a quick trip into the mines. But as you can see, I did quite a bit of logging. Trees still have to come back. I also made me a cooling shirt, because as expected, I was overheating with the helmet on my head. And it did get August already. Took me quite a while to do everything. But the iron tools have been a blessing. So I often just go take a quick trip into the mines, just one time in and out, and then continue on with whatever I was doing. If I had to wait on something, and more iron is always needed, so that's good. There we are. Another iron. Let's go. So right now I'm working on my greenhouse, of course, as you could see. I'm only missing 5 nails for the first one. And then I'm also at the same time needing nails for my ingot shelves. And I'm needing iron for my extractor that I'll be moving to the aluminum, where I will also build me a nice little house. As well as trying to find me some more melons and watermelons. But that will become easier as soon as I get my greenhouse up and running, because then I can plant them. You need about 100 water to fill up one planter box. So with a large flask you can still water two plants at a time. Until of course you get a water house and you don't have to water them at all anymore. And if you don't have enough power to leave your water on permanently, you just have to toggle it on for a few seconds. I usually just count to 5 and then it's all set to go. And then you can turn it off again and put on whatever else you needed. Quite a bit of iron today. We have 6 pieces already. Let that one stand. So let's go out. The iron should be melted by now. Let's put these one in and then we can finish our very first greenhouse. The reason why I put 2 is just because I had the space for it and it can't hurt to have a lot of vegetables growing. There we go. Let's make them into screws. There we go, our very first greenhouse. So, something handy is that it's always 23 degrees in here. So, even in the winter, you can just go in here and you'll be nice and toasty. Even during blizzards. Let's just put some planter boxes down for now. Four there, and then 4 on this side. Let's just start with that. 8 plank, 8 nails. Of course I only have 15 nails, but that's not too bad. Move that around so I can take a full stack with me. Let's get another stack. Well, while we're at it, let's place some more planter boxes. Food. There we go. And let's go get some more planks. Thank you. need some more planks. Nope, that's the ingot house. This is the planting house. I need another 16, I'd grab them from this place. And that's 16, so let's build them up. Let's go get ourselves the iron. One in here, and then make 50 nails. There we go. And since I'm getting quite a bit of copper, let's finish ourselves a copper shell. 15 planks for that one. That's easy enough. And let's put copper in there. There we go. So that's nicely done, and then let's get ourselves some seeds. Some melon and some watermelon. Let's put these away before I use them. Nope, not that one. This one. No melons in this one. And let's just go and get water. I can always boil fresh water, so that's not a big deal. So we'll have to run back and forth 3 times to water all the plants for now. You could always place a water basin out here, but since that needs 10 iron ingots, which is quite expensive, I'm not going to do that just yet. It's not that far away for me to fill my flask. That's also why I put the greenhouse right there. And one more time to water the plants, and then maybe once more just to have some water on me. And then we can actually go and see what else I can do to finish things up. I have quite a few things I can just finish, but I just haven't gotten to it yet. There we go, that's all the water. And then now water for drinking. We'll be needing some firewood, so let's chop some down. So, 2 firewood. Harvest these up. And we'll need 2 more. 1, 2, and that's 1 finished window. Then, next up. Do we have the screws? No, we do not. So, let's get us some copper. Let's put back the seeds. One has the screws. And it's raining again. So let's put in the planks. These 19 in this one for now. Oh wait, that one has them. Do you have that? No, you do not. And do you have that? Not doesn't either. There we go. I don't like an even amount of planks. I'll fix that later. That's the first 20. Another 20, so that one only needs the iron ingots. And I have another 6 left over. The last one here did use it, is able to use 3 more. 1 left. I have more extractors to build, so more places to get rid of that one. Oh hey, that one also just has 1. There we go. last ones. And we need a lot more iron. The extractor is a little bit slow, that's why it's more than one. But it also has two. Excuse me. That one only needs the bricks. I will have to do a lot of mining and well, mostly mining. Oh, another melon. Let's see if we can find us a watermelon. No corn. Is always good because we won't be needing bricks for our second board. And I see some more clay, but do I see watermelons? Oh, rain, stop with this rain fog. I don't see any watermelons, sadly. This is all the clay I need for my brick fort, so let's go and do that real fast. Where are the watermelons? I usually see plenty of watermelons around this time of year, but for some reason they are hiding today. And the corn growing next to my greenhouse. So let's make 40 bricks to start with. That's 20, 30, and 40. So we have to wait till that is dry now. Watermelon, where are you? Oh, Hey, Mr. Piggy, have you seen a watermelon? Silent type. I guess no watermelons at the moment. Since I haven't gotten my clean water yet, because I don't really need it just yet, I can just get me dirty water, and when I get back in my town, I can fill the planter boxes again. So, yeah, by next episode I will likely have been into the mines like a bazillion times and have gotten me quite a bit of iron, I hope, so that we can start to finish up a lot of things. I will probably just melt them already beforehand, so you can all have the satisfaction of looking to see how things finish. Because I know that's the best part of it, having a big build, having everything finish up, and starting to look pretty. I will also try to start making me some bricks so I can wall up some of my brick up some of my houses. Because I do prefer the looks of a brick house over that wooden hut thingy. But yeah, I won't be doing a lot more logging because I still have a lot left. Yeah, I'll just spend an entirety into the mines. Excuse me. I've been outside and now I have an itch in my throat because of the pollen. But yeah, like you can see, still a lot of ores in the caves. Don't have to worry about lead because every single node gives you 2 lead, like I said last time. Plenty deposits, also quite a bit of iron. You just have to keep at it and you'll have enough iron for nearly everything. Just don't give up, keep at it, and you'll get what you need eventually. And if not by mining, the extractor will help. But yeah, I hope you all have a wonderful day. I will see you on the next episode, and then we shall finish up a lot more things. Thanks for watching, and yeah, have a wonderful day again.